Okay, so moving on to the next team in the Big Ten we will be going over today. This is going to be the team that I have predicted to come in seventh place in this conference, and that would be Chris Holtmann and the Ohio State Buckeyes. And I do think, to start off the bat, I will say Chris Holtmann is one of the more underrated coaches in all of college basketball. I think that what he's been able to do since he's gotten to Ohio State has been really impressive, and I feel like the last couple of years, Ohio State has been so good that it's very easy for people to forget that when he started off his tenure at Ohio State, the program was not left in a great position by Thad Matta. Things kind of unraveled there pretty quickly, and immediately Chris Holtmann was able to lead this group to the NCAA tournament, which was just super, super impressive. But for this year's Buckeyes team, I do think they're a team where I see why some people are going to be really high on them. Other people are going to be low on them. It really just depends where your opinion falls. And I'm right in the middle on them. But I do think they have a potential to be a really good team. And I do think if they were playing in another league that wasn't the Big Ten, I would be even higher on them. You're going to see them at 7th in my Big Ten rankings, and you're going to say, you know, you're high on them? Yes, I am actually very high on this Ohio State team. I think they are clearly an NCAA tournament team. I think they're better than Michigan. I think they're better than Purdue, and I'll tell you why. Now, off the bat, you're going to realize that Ohio State did lose two of their better players from last year. That was obviously going to be an NCAA tournament team with the two Wesson brothers and Luther Muhammad and DJ Carton. So four really important players that played a significant role on last year's Ohio State Buckeye team. And Caleb Wesson was just so good at really enforcing his will. He was a big man that could shoot, which is obviously something that not a lot of other teams throughout college basketball have. And I was really impressed with the way his game developed throughout his career as an Ohio State Buckeye. And they lose Andre Wesson, who was one of the more important role players and glue guys on this Ohio State team. And I believe Andre Wesson was a pretty big reason why, over the last couple of years, Ohio State was so successful. Luther Muhammad was probably the best pure on-ball defender on this Ohio State team. He decides to transfer to Arizona State. That was a little bit of a surprise during the offseason, but I guess when you look deeper at all the different wings Ohio State has, it wasn't that shocking of a decision. And then they also lose DJ Carton, who he actually left the team, I believe it was halfway through last season, and we spoke about him during the Marquette preview, during the Big East preview podcast edition. I really like DJ Carton and how he's able to play, but at the same time, I do think there are positions where this Ohio State team has the depth to replace him, and that starts off with the starting backcourt, and they return both members of their starting backcourt from last year's squad, including CJ Walker, who I think is one of the more underrated and underappreciated players in all of college basketball. The 6'1 senior averaged 8.7 points per game last year, 3 rebounds and about 3.5 assists. And CJ Walker is underrated because he was actually the starting point guard on that very good Florida State team a couple years ago that actually made the Elite Eight and lost to Michigan. Plus, he was on a very good Ohio State team last year, and he is just a guy that has experience playing winning basketball, which in 2020, that is not something a lot of other teams in college basketball have. They also bring back a guy in Dwayne Washington Jr., who is one of the more surprising players in all of college basketball last year. He averaged 11.5 points per game, 3 rebounds per game, and he really established himself in a role as the go-to shooter for this Ohio State Buckeye team. And I think him with CJ Walker could actually end up playing really well together. And then they also bring in a couple transfers. Justice Suing, who in 2018-2019 with Cal averaged 14.3 points per game and 6 rebounds per game, 2 assists per game as well. I think he's a really good fit for the modern day style of basketball. And I think if you're playing a lineup with him and Dwayne Washington on the floor together, that is shooting and size that not a lot of other teams are able to replicate, plus EJ Liddell, plus Kyle Young, a guy that Chris Holtmann always loves to get him minutes in the rotation. He's another glue guy that is really helpful for this Ohio State squad. Seth Towns was the other guy I mentioned. He is the transfer from Harvard, and there are obviously some concerns with Seth Towns and his injury history. In 17-18, he averaged 16 points per game, 5.7 rebounds per game, and 1.8 assists per game. But ultimately, the question is going to be his health and how much he's going to be on the floor for this upcoming season. Because when you look at Seth Towns throughout his career, he's been very successful. It's just always been a question of can he stay healthy and can he get on the floor. They also will bring back Kyle Young and EJ Liddell. I think having these two guys in the front court could really help because Young is fiery and physical. He's a very good rebounder for his size, and he really is a guy that you could ask Chris Holtman. The Ohio State Buckeyes are just better when Kyle Young is on the floor doing his thing. And last year in January, that's when Ohio State really started to struggle, and that's when Kyle Young had an ankle injury and missed even more time after getting his appendix removed. And then EJ Liddell is a kid I really like. He's a little undersized at 6'6", but he was a monster shot blocker in high school, and that carried into his first college season, ranking 9th in the Big Ten in block rate. And then they also bring in the sophomore Ibrahima Diallo. He's the only true center on the roster, so he'll be given every chance to play. But Holtman may feel inclined to use the team's deep group of forwards instead if he struggles. So I think if he wants to get on the floor, he's going to have to produce right away. And Caleb Wesson, he was the focal point of the offense. And I feel like it's going to be very interesting to see who exactly Ohio State could bring in or who could they develop this season that is going to fill that role. And I feel like without that one true center, they might just be better playing Kyle Young at the five. And I feel like if I'm Chris Holtman, that would be the way I would do it and just build your lineup around high, tall, athletic, lanky wings. So the other two players I wanted to talk about quickly for this Ohio State team, number one is Justin Arns, who is the brother of Kyle Arns, Michigan Stater. He is a really one-trick pony, but when that trick is hitting over 40% from three, it's worth bringing that pony to the show. Chris Holtman also snagged Abel Porter from Utah State. I think he could be a guy that could ultimately fulfill the role of Andrew Dockich for this Ohio State Buckeye team. If you remember a couple years ago, he really succeeded as that quality backup point guard that just provides you with depth, and I feel like Abel Porter could be a guy who could do that on this Ohio State team, considering the fact that he was very productive throughout his career at Utah State and played for a lot of really good teams during his time there. So I'm a fan of what he could do. I'm a fan of freshman's Zed Key as well. I think he adds to the depth, and he's a really underrated big man that could maybe serve as a strong back-to-the-basket scorer for this Ohio State team as well. So I'm pretty high on this Ohio State team. I have them finishing in 7th in the Big Ten, but I have them right inside my top 25, and I think they're really good. I think they could be one of the sleeper teams in college basketball that not a lot of people are talking about now, and really that's what Chris Holtman has done throughout his college career, is just earn victories when people don't necessarily expect him to do so.